In today's video, I'm going to show you how to turn trending articles into YouTube videos. So I've made a similar video to this in the past, but ever since that video came out, there's been some great new updates that makes it way easier to create trending content for YouTube. So in today's video, I'm going to show you three easy steps that you can take to create your first YouTube video. And if you follow along with all the steps that I'm about to show you, you'll also have a video that's done and ready to upload to YouTube. So the first step is to find an article or a blog post that you want to make a video on. The second step is to rewrite that article using AI content creation tools. Then we're going to create a video from the script that you've just written. So these are just three simple steps that you need to take, and all the tools that we're about to use are free tools. So the links to all the tools will be in the description below. These tools are free, and it also comes with some paid upgrades. But you can use it for free just to start with, and then you can upgrade to a paid version once you've start making some money from YouTube AdSense, or you might get some sales and so on. So make sure you follow along with the video so you'll have your first video ready to upload to YouTube. But before we actually get started with the video, make sure you hit the like button, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and comment down below with any questions or any other video requests that you have. And if you do all three of those things, you'll be in the draw to win the YouTube Masterclass course. So if you don't know what YouTube Masterclass is, there'll be a link to it, the first link to it in the description below. It's packed with everything that you need to know about how to start a YouTube channel, how to grow the YouTube channel, and how to monetize the YouTube channel in multiple ways. And if you just hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and comment on this video, you'll be in the draw to win the course. So I pick a new winner every single week. So let's pick last week's winner. So I'm going to go into last week's video right here, copy the link to the video, and I use this website called Pick a Winner, and it's going to go through everyone that's liked the video, commented on the video, and subscribed to the channel, and it's going to pick a random winner. So Abel Aham, so you are the winner of the YouTube Masterclass course. All you need to do is email me at help@dreamcloudacademy.com. So the email will be at the bottom of this video's description. You just need to email me with this Gmail account. So you should have a Gmail account. Just email me with that account so I'll know that it's you, and I'll give you access to the course. So if you want to win just like Abel, just hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below with any questions or video requests. So with that said, let's get started with today's video. So step one is to find a blog post or an article that you want to turn into a video. So I'm not going to go into how to find trending topics or trending articles in this video. If you want to learn more about that, then you can check out the YouTube Masterclass course. But I just want to show you just a simple way to find an article. So let's say productivity hacks are trending on YouTube. I would just simply go into Google and I would just search up something like what makes people productive. Then go into tools right here and look for articles that were written within the past week to a month. So just filter it right here and find some articles right here. So people who are insanely productive have these six things in common. So that's from lifehack.org. There's one from here called due.com. So try to filter articles that have been uploaded or created within the past week to a month. And you can do that with the tools section right here in Google search. So I found this article here called What Makes Some People More Productive Than Others. So this article is quite old, but it is a good article. So I decided to turn this into a YouTube video. So that's the first step done. So don't spend too much time trying to find the perfect article, because what we're going to do is rewrite the article into our own words. So the tool that we're going to use to rewrite the article is writer.me. So I've made a lot of tutorials on writer.me before, but those tutorials were only on how to create your own original content from scratch with Writer. If you want to rewrite something, then there's a different way of doing it, and that's what I'm going to show you in today's video. So you might be thinking, why would I want to rewrite someone else's article when I can actually write my own article from with Writer or any other AI writing assistant tools? Well, if you write the entire article using an AI, then you have to do the fact-checking yourself. So if you have to do the fact-checking yourself, that's more work, and the AI doesn't always get things right. But if you rewrite the article from a well-known website like Harvard Business Review, then they've already done the research for you. Then all you need to do is just simply rewrite it and add some of your own original content in there. So that's what we're going to do in today's video. So first thing is I'm going to copy this headline. So let's copy this heading and let's paste that in. And make sure it's highlighted as a heading right here. So this H1 tag means that's a heading. Then we're going to make it bold. And then once you've highlighted this, just click on rephrase. It's as simple as that. So it just rewrote that heading into what do people have in common who are more productive than most. So if you don't like this heading, just hit Control Z or Command Z if you're on a Mac, and it's going to undo that. Now click on rephrase again, and it's going to rewrite it for you. Now keep in mind, if you're using the free version, you can only create up to 5,000 words per month. Then after that, it's $30 per month, and you can write unlimited words. So if you keep clicking on undo and keep rephrasing the word, then you might be using up all of your monthly quota that you have. So let's have a look at this one. So it says some people are naturally more productive when it comes to their work. What is their secret? So that's a good heading. And let's go back to the second paragraph. So I'm going to copy all of this right here. And you'll notice that sometimes it can't rewrite everything by itself. Sometimes you have to kind of guide it. So I'll show you what I mean soon. So let's rewrite this. So you'll also notice, so this is just a short question right here. So that it can instantly just get that rewritten within a few seconds. But the more you highlight, the longer it takes. So the maximum you can highlight is 300 characters. So what I recommend is you do one sentence at a time. So let's highlight this and rephrase this. And you can see it actually wrote quite a bit there. So that, let's leave that as it is and let's keep going. So usually what I do is I take a paragraph and I'll rewrite each sentence one by one. And then I'll read the entire sentence and just kind of add in my own content or my own original thoughts in there. So let's highlight this and rephrase this. That's good. And let's highlight the last sentence and rephrase that. So you might notice that this doesn't rewrite it properly. Okay, so it actually has done that properly. But when you read through it, you might notice that it has actually didn't write this properly or doesn't make sense. So let's read through this. So on a scale from 1 to 10, how productive are you? Ever since we've been learning about what makes people more productive, we've been able to use that information to help us create a more productive environment. Last year, we published a survey to help professionals assess their own levels of productivity. We defined it as being able to accomplish more each day through specific habits. The survey looked into 7 habits that seem to be effective for people. These are developing daily routines, managing your time effectively, coping with messages in your inbox, getting a lot done in your day-to-day task, running effective meetings, mastering communication skills, and taking on responsibility wisely. So that actually wrote everything really nicely. So I'm actually surprised about that. So usually you have to kind of add in your own content in there, here and there, just to make it a bit more... how can I say it? Just to make it more seem like it's been actually been written by a proper human instead of like an AI. So but that's actually good as it is. But we're not done here just yet. So since we just rewrote this article right here, we need to check, is there any plagiarism here? So we need to highlight this and go into here and click on check for plagiarism. And it says no matches found. So let's say if I actually copy this exactly as it is. And let me just paste this in right here. And let's check for plagiarism here. So usually if there is just even a little bit of plagiarism, it's going to pick up on that. And it's going to tell you this is 70% matching with this. So it says 100% matching with this, 100% matching with this website here, 91%, 70%. So you can see all of these other websites have actually used the same article. So that's why it's matching. So when there is plagiarism, it will definitely pick it up, but every time you rephrase it using writer.me, there's usually no plagiarism. But if there is plagiarism, just highlight it again and click on rephrase again. So that's the first paragraph done. Now you just keep going with the entire article and get the entire script done. So what I just did is I went through the article and I picked a few of the paragraphs and I turned it into a 500-word article right here. And on top of that, I also added in some of my own original content, like I wrote an intro paragraph with Writer, and I also wrote a conclusion. So if you want to learn how to use Writer in more detail, I'll leave a link to that in the description below. But we've got an article rewritten now with Writer. So now it's time to turn this into a video. So we're going to highlight the text right here. And let's copy this and go into invideo.io. So I'll leave a link to this tool in the description below. And this is a great tool, and it's also a free tool to turn any article or text into a YouTube video. So once you sign up for a free account, this is what the dashboard will look like. And right here, there'll be three options. So click on text to video right here and choose a template that you want. So what we want is a wide video for YouTube, but you can also pick a square video or a vertical video. And we're going to pick a theme. So let's pick maybe this one right here. Yep, so that's pretty good. Oh, might actually be a bit too much. Maybe let's try this one. So this one seems a bit more like a productivity video. So let's choose this one. So you can watch through the video right here with sound and then click on use this template. And right here, this is where you paste in the article that you just rewrote. And then let's go back to Writer, and then let's copy the headline as well, which is the heading. And let's paste that in right here as well. So then we have to click on next. But before we actually click on next, make sure you have auto suggest images and videos clicked on. So what it's going to do is it's an AI that actually reads through the article that you given it, and it's going to try to figure out what kind of images should be in the video, what kind of videos should be in the video, and these are all copyright free images that you can use. So, and on top of that, when you click on next, it's going to ask you a question. So it's going to ask you, should I rearrange this text? So what does this mean? So what we just did is we took the entire article and we pasted that into InVideo. So it's going to say that's a lot of text right here. Should you rearrange the text into like little small bullet points? And InVideo will do that for you. So make sure you click on rearrange text if you have a lot of text already added in. And then click on next again. And now it's going to just rearranged everything for you. Now it's just going to create the video for you now. Now, sometimes there will be an error message if the video is too complex. Just try it again and it'll work the second time around. And I've never really gotten this all the time, but sometimes there is an error message. So if you do have an error message, just refresh and then go back and just put in those, just do the same thing over again and it'll create the video for you. So in this case, it actually did everything right. You can see it's broken everything down into small bullet points that are readable. But let's say we want to edit something. So first thing is, how do you edit the images? So right here, here's an image. That's already a pretty good image, but let's say you want to add in a video instead. So what we're going to do is go right here to video, and there'll be some copyright-free images, images and videos that we can use. So right here, I'm going to search up productivity. And hit search. And anything with this little pro icon, so there's this little king icon right here, those ones you have to pay for. But the other ones here without that icon, you can use those ones for free. So let's find something that's that relates to our video. So let's use this one right here. So I'm going to click and drag this, and I'm going to drag that in right here. And I'm going to say use the entire video. So you can only use a part of the video if you wanted to, but if you like the entire video, just click on use full video. And then I'm going to edit this further. So right now you can see it's going to play this image first, and then it's going to play this second image. So I want to edit that. So click on edit. And what I want to do is get rid of that first image. So right here, there's this image right here. So I'm going to click on delete. So there's right where it says media. We can push this back. And we can also push the entire video back right here as well. And let's make this a bit longer. It's perfect. And we can also move it to the side right here. So that's good. Now click on save. And there it is. So now that looks much better. Now let's say you want to add a different text in here. Maybe that's too much text. So now go back in here, click on edit. And just like before, I'm going to click on this and you can rewrite this into something else. So maybe you want to get rid of the second sentence and hit back. And on top of that, you can also add in another image if you wanted to. So maybe some other image that could, maybe this image doesn't relate. So you have to add in another image. So maybe let's search up something again like productive. And instead of a video, I actually want an image. So sure, I clicked on image right here. So let me just click on productive right here. And let's see here. So most of these ones you have to pay for. So I'm just trying to find the paid ones. So let's get rid of iStock. Oh, so they actually don't have anything for productive. Interesting. So let's try something else like work. There we go. So I'll just use this instead. And I'll click on replace. And it's going to replace that entire image. So I'm going to make this a little bit bigger and place that in right here. And that's it. Now you just keep going with the entire timeline now. So right here, it says so far this video is 3 minutes long. I would try to create a video that's at least 8 minutes long so you can actually add in some mid-roll ads. If you don't know what mid-roll ads are, you can check out my YouTube Masterclass course. Basically, it's a way to make more money from the ads that get run on your YouTube videos, and also a good way to get more watch time on your YouTube videos. So make sure you try to make your videos at least 8 minutes long. So right now it's 3 minutes, so I'm just gonna, just to keep this video quick, I'm just gonna leave it as it is and click on download and share. And right now I'm using the free version, but if you want to, so we can only download it as 720p. And some people think that you'll get less views just because you upload it at 720p. That's actually not true. I've had plenty of videos that get a lot of views at 720p. So just to start off, you can start off with a free account and upload videos at 720p. But once you start making some money, you should definitely upgrade to the paid version and start uploading some high definition videos. So I'm just going to leave this as 720p and click on export. So once this finishes exporting, then I'll come back to this. So I'm just going to skip ahead to that. So you can see it right here. It's at 2%. So once this finishes exporting, I'll come back to this and you simply click on download. So the video just finished rendering right here. And so all you do is just click on download right here. And this is what it looks like. So it says download here with watermark. But for some reason from the software, sometimes I get a watermark and sometimes I don't. So in this example here, I can't see a watermark. So let me just, I'm gonna lower the volume because it might be copyrighted music since I don't have a paid version of in video. So I'm gonna lower the music right here and let's hit play. So you can see the video plays. There's the stock video that we've just added with the bullet point in right here. And you can keep going and it's just this. This is all what it created for us. So that's it. So now you can upload this video as it is. So it's ready to go. It's a good high definition video, even though it's only 720p. You can see that it still looks really good. So it's good as it is, but it is good to add in some voiceover. So you can add in your own voiceover with your own voice, or you can use an AI to do it for you. So this last step is optional. So we can add in some voiceover with wellsaidlabs.com. So this is my favorite tool to add in voiceovers, and I've tested whether you can actually monetize videos with the voiceover from Wellsaid Labs. And I've tested hundreds of videos and all of them stayed monetized. So I can safely say that the voiceovers that you create with wellsaidlabs.com stay monetized. Now I'm testing some other softwares right now and I'll let you guys know how all of those softwares do. But all the tests that I've done so far with Wellsaid Labs have stayed monetized. So to turn this into a voiceover, all you do is just simply copy the first few paragraphs right here. You can't just copy everything in all at once. And let's paste that in right here and click on create. So now what it's going to do is it's going to go through all of this entire article and it's going to create the voiceover. and usually only takes like 30 seconds to do that. So while it's doing that, I'm gonna go back to my video editor and I'm actually gonna upload this download right here. So let me just go back and download this. I'm just gonna download it again. And let's go back here and I'm gonna click and drag that in. And this is probably done now. Yep, so let's listen to this. So let me just make sure that you guys can hear this.
Some people are naturally more productive when it comes to their work, but what is their secret?
So that sounds good as it is. I'm not going to play the entire thing, but just from that first sentence, I think that sounds good enough. So usually I would play the whole thing and make sure it sounds good. So I'm not going to go through the entire article and create a voiceover from it. So I'm just going to, because that would go through my credits, but I'm just going to take that first a few paragraphs here, and let's turn this into a normal video now. So let's add this. And I'm gonna turn the volume all the way down because I don't want the music from the video to be in there. So I'm gonna turn the volume all the way down. And let's add the voiceover in now. And on top of that, I wanna add in some copyright free music. So let's click on plus right here, click on audio, click on add track, and let's go into audio right here. So these are some of the copyright free music from vvideo.com. So if you wanna learn more about how to create your own music with AI, then I'll leave a link to another video in the description below. So this sounds pretty good, so I'm going to take this one and I'm going to lower the volume on this to like 10%, and I'm just going to up the volume so I can hear it properly, and let's hit play and let's see what all of this looks like. So it's just
different people, but in reality there are many ways to increase your productivity levels. Some of these ways include dedicating specific times of the day for different tasks, prioritizing what you need to.
So obviously right there, the text doesn't actually align with what the voiceover is saying. So what I can do right here is just cut some of the video and also clip some of the voiceover as well, so it actually matches the video with the voiceover. So the voiceover is kind of going a bit too fast for the video. So that's just some basic video editing that you need to do here and there. So I'm not going to do that in this video. You can, if you want to learn a bit more about video editing, I've got another video on how to use vvideo.com. There's plenty of tutorials online on how to do some basic video editing like cutting and clipping. You can check that out. But basically just this video as it is without the voiceover is perfect for you to ready to upload to YouTube. And also you can get into much more detail with InVideo and make it like good high quality content. So add in some better images in there, you can also add in some better videos from pixels.com, which is a great website for copyright free images and videos. So use some videos from there and you can upload that into InVideo, and you can create some great content with Writer and InVideo. So the last step is optional, which is to add in your own voiceover. So that's it for today's video. If you have any questions, make sure you comment down below. Make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you do all three of those things, you'll be in the draw to win my YouTube Masterclass course. And on top of that, if you guys have already bought the YouTube Masterclass course, make sure you go request access on dreamcloud.studio to all of the new tools that I've been releasing, which is tools to help you grow your YouTube channel. So if you don't know what dreamcloud.studio is, I made a video on that before. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. So I'll be making more videos on all the tools that I'll be creating very soon. So stay tuned for that. And with that said, I'll see you in next week's video.